Hey, Ava Reed here, and I'm going to show you a really quick Kajabi hack that I just figured out. I just found out, actually, and I'm really excited about it. So, a little backstory. I came from WordPress to Kajabi, and so my custom domain, AvaReed.com, was with WordPress, and I had WordPress for a while. I've done guest blog posts. I've done guest podcasts. And so when I'm sending people to my freebie, I'm giving them my link. Well, when I migrated over to Kajabi, I was able to take my custom domain over to Kajabi, but all those old blog posts and all those old podcasts that I don't own, they belong to somebody else. They have the old link to my opt-in. So I had two options. I could either try to remember who all I guess blog posts and podcasts and have done Facebook Lives for and send them the updated link. Too bad that Kajabi doesn't have its own little pretty link. I love pretty link with WordPress, but you know, Kajabi doesn't have anything like that now. And then my other option was to look up and see, okay, what other services other than Pretty Link are there that I can use for Kajabi? Well, as I was Googling, I found a YouTube video where this guy teaches how to do exactly what I wanna do. So I wanna take my the link that I shared with so many people back in 2017, 18, early 19, and redirect them to my new link where my freebie is at currently. So, and it's with code. So I found this video, and the way he does it wasn't exactly how I needed it done. It added extra text to the end of my custom domain. And so it wouldn't have worked with my old links migrating completely, but I figured out a workaround. So I am going to post his video in the description below to give him homage and credit, because it was his inspiration that I kind of used his teachings and found my own workaround to make it work for what I needed. Okay, so let's jump into it. So here we are in Kajabi. And this is a way that if you like the pretty link feature and you're trying to figure out, or maybe you're paying for the service somewhere else, you can do this instead and it's totally free. Okay, so I'm gonna go to, so here we are at the dashboard. I'm gonna go to website and then I'm gonna go to pages. So now that I'm here in pages, I'm gonna click on new page. And I don't really need a pretty page. I really just need like a blank page. So I'm gonna scroll down and grab this thank you page that is pretty blank. It's nothing really there. I'm gonna click on get started. And then from here, I'm gonna title it, I think I'm gonna redirect people to my my membership waitlist. So I'm gonna call it Webinar Club Waitlist. And then I hit create. Okay, so now Kajabi is creating that page. Everything is good. Okay, so I just need this to be completely blank. I don't need all this extra stuff. So what I'm actually gonna do is delete this call to action. Let me move my video over. So I'm gonna delete that block. Okay, and now I have this block, which is saying, thank you for signing up. I'm just gonna come in here and delete all of this. So it's completely, nothing is there. All right, so this is what it looks like. Now, what you're gonna wanna do is click on this when you're in the text section, the source code, and it's gonna bring up a window for your source code. Now the code I'm going to use, and I'm going to have this code in the description below. This is the code that I'm going to use. Okay. Now, in these quotation marks. So what I have highlighted is the link that I want this page to redirect to. So that's whatever link you want to redirect to. So if you want people to click on your Kajabi link and they go over to an affiliate link on Amazon and then don't have to see all that extra gobbledygook that Amazon affiliate links have, you can do this. If you don't want them to see the bit.ly link, you can do this as well. So whatever you want them to land on. So I have my webinar club waitlist here. So I'm gonna delete it out. And so where the cursor is where you would put your link. So I'm just going to grab it and stick it back in there. And then you're gonna hit okay. And voila. Oh wait, I have to hit save. You save and then voila. Boom, okay, there it is. So that's good. Okay, now, one other thing I need for me is I need to grab that link that I'm going to share with people. So let me hit back again. And here's the page I just created, Webinar Club Waitlist. So I'm gonna click on these three dots and I'm gonna click on Edit Details. And from here, it's got my custom domain, www.aprille.com/, and then whatever I want this to say, this is what I can share. And then they're going to send, so when somebody clicks on this link, it's going to take them to the page you just saw. So I believe the old link was /, well, I think it was just waitlist. Hit save. So www.aprille.com/waitlist. That link is the link that I've used in 2018. So now when somebody is on that podcast episode and they're in the show notes and they click on the link and it's not going to no longer take them to a 404 page. It's going to take them to my waitlist where the new link is. It's just going to redirect. And the only reason I'm doing this now is because I got an email today where somebody was like, oh, by the way, your link on It's a Tribe thing, it's not working. And I'm like, oh my gosh, that's right. They have the old link. So if you have that same issue, or if you just want a workaround in order to, oh, let me show you it working. So let me save and then let me copy this link and I'll show you how it works. And so let's just grab a new one. And then I'm gonna paste the new link here and you're gonna see it redirect. Boom. All right, so there you have it. Bye. Let me know if you have any questions below. See ya.